Hey everybody, what's up? How you doing? It's Broman. We're back with another Borderlands 3 video. And in the interest of answering all of the questions that you all have, I forgot to turn my balls on again. We're going to address something that's coming up a lot from veteran players, and that is the question of endgame progression and or badass rank. So this is a paused video of like the quarter of a second I knew that I spent on this screen from our stream from Gearbox. So here you can see that badass rank and game progression or character progression is now shown as guardian rank. So this is a new system. It is locked until the end of the story. In the middle, it's got a tooltip telling you to return after completing all the story missions for more rewards. Behind my face back here above and below, you can kind of see it says bonus stats. It says Enforcer, Survivor, and Hunter. The Enforcer tree says critical damage, grenade damage, gunfire rate, melee damage, and vehicle. So Enforcer is damage increase. Survivor is fight for your life duration, fight for your life movement speed, max health, shield capacity, shield recharge delay, and shield recharge rate. So Survivor is all about your health, your shields, and your ability to apparently increase your fight for your life stack. And Hunter is accuracy, action kill cooldown, luck, which is rarity rate, recoil reduction, and recoil speed. And you get these skills by redeeming guardian tokens. So something that's really important to point out is, unlike weapon proficiency and unlike badass rank, this is something that is going to be gained after you finish the story. If you look at a lot of the other mechanics that are in the game, especially around guns and gun manufacturers, where you have specific pointed challenges and quests that are going to give you increases and loyalty or whatever to that brand of manufacturer, whether it's Vladov, whatever, it would not be a hard leap to make, even though we haven't been able to dig into this yet, that these paths, these guardian tokens that you're going to be able to earn, are going to be directed pathways for you as a vault hunter and or maybe more importantly a guardian to grow your skill tree in a meaningful and directed path. So we all know that in Borderlands 1 we had weapon proficiency, which was a directed path. So you use SMGs a lot, you're going to have SMG strength increase damage with SMGs, reload speed, aiming down sights, where accuracy, all that stuff. That was Borderlands 1. Borderlands 2, we had badass rank, which gave the illusion of choice, but over a long scale, it is a normalized increase across all of your stats, because the randomized choice you are given was in fact funneled in a specific direction so that you couldn't, you know, overweight one increase. Appears on the face of it that that will not be the case with guardian rank. The fact that you're going to have enforcer, survivor, and hunter trees means that there are probably going to be skills and actions that you can take that will specifically increase your critical damage or specifically increase your grenade damage or gun rate. Some of the things that really intrigue me here are in the hunter tree, specifically luck. The fact that there might be something you can do, and this might be something as simple as picking up rare weapons or finding more legendaries in order to complete challenges, you are going to have control over how much you increase your luck and rarity rate based off of how much you play. Guardian rank looks much more like directed meta growth, which is growth beyond the game, character growth that maybe will transfer between characters, maybe not. That you are going to be rewarded for playing for a long time on one character in particular, or across all of your guardians, but the active bonuses won't be there until after you finish the story, which I think is a really, it's cool. It makes your first playthrough with any character feel more meaningful when you have to struggle, instead of having badass rank out the ass and you're twice as powerful the entire time as you were. When you open up your second or third or fourth or fifth or 75th Vault Hunter. Overall, I'm very excited that this Guardian rank system has been introduced. The fact that we're going to have abilities to build out our fight for our life or movement speed and fight for your life and luck outside of the stuff we're used to getting with badass rank is really, really cool. The luck stat is incredibly intriguing to me personally, because it means that, you know, somewhere there is a roll number inside of the game's engine that is helping decide things for you, and we are going to be able to influence that by, you know, increasing our luck rarity, which is, thank God, on the screen directly below my camera. So I am excited about the Guardian rank system. I would love to know what you all think in the comments section below. As usual, you can check me out anywhere you want. I'm on Twitter, I'm on Instagram, I got a podcast, all that shit. But the one number one thing I would like for you to do is, you know, share this with somebody that you think cares about it. And yeah, that's about it. Guardian ranks got me excited. I'm really looking forward to what it means for the game over the long term. And I can't wait to play more. Talk to you next time. Peace.